these last days, it's been said that we're endeavoring to understand the nature of emptiness. Not emptiness, but the nature of emptiness. Because since emptiness, like the mind, is not an entity, it has no existence. But it's also been said that we cannot understand the nature of emptiness until we've answered the question or made a reconciliation between stillness and movement. What is it that occurs when they meet in us? With our mind, we can know that the movement is in the stillness, and the stillness is in the movement. Just as the wave is in the particle, and the particle is in the wave, or the ocean is in the drop, and the drop is in the ocean. Mula Nasruddin was walking down the road one day when he met a monk, and they got into a philosophical discussion. And the monk said, "I am in such an advanced state of mind. I am so detached from myself that I only think of others. I never think of myself." Mula Nasruddin said, "Oh, my mind is more advanced than yours, because I am so objective that I see everyone as myself, so I'm able to think of me." A certain Zen seeker came to the great Zen master Fu Chao, and he said, "Master, Zen means mind. And it is known that mind is equally in the Buddha as in ordinary men. And yet the patriarchs refer to it as nature or Buddha nature. Master, tell me, what is the difference between mind and nature?" And Master Fu Chao replied, "There is only a difference if one is deluded. To the enlightened, there is no difference." And the acolyte replied, "How come it is then said in the sutras that nature is permanent and mind is impermanent? How then can you say there is no difference?" And the master replied, "You are only interpreting the words. You are not understanding their implication. When water is made cold, it becomes ice. This is mind. Only when one is deluded is it known and seen as mind. To the enlightened, there is no difference." experience now, being in that place where there is what we can perceive and know to our mind as stillness, and yet have all the movements of life, which are equally as perceivable by our senses, meet that stillness at every moment. We are also then able to experience, and therefore understand and express what it is that occurs when they meet. Just like when we say the wave is in the particle, and the particle is in the wave, or the stillness is in the movement, and the movement is in the stillness, we know it as an absolute, because it's an experience that occurs at every moment. If we can come to answer this question, or find a meeting place between our knowing of this and the experience that's occurring, we have a possibility of understanding. In listening to these two little anecdotes, what arises out of them for you? What does it mean, this little story of the morning? I'm so objective that I see everyone as myself, so therefore I can think of. And this relationship, which is not a relationship at all, although to our mind we can make a difference, Buddha nature and mind. The ice and the water, the wave and the particle, still is a movement. What is it that's occurring in each one of us as at every moment the movement of life meets this, which we can perceive as presence, being here now, mind, body and spirit integrated, subject and under, existence, knowledge and bliss as one.